if you take into account the fact that there's so much more radiography generated in dentistry than any other form of medicine, you also have a dynamic where there is a real lack of concurrence amongst practitioners when it comes to reading radiography. So, you know, some stats that we quote sometimes, you know, 43% of caries go undiagnosed. 20% of the caries that are diagnosed are not actually, you know, decay. 49% of periapical lesions go undiagnosed. And we've run lots of studies around this and they're published on our website. And if you look at any individual study, then you'll find just very striking results. You know, in 1997, a journalist for the Reader's Digest decided to go to 50 states in the US and get 50 diagnoses and treatment plans from 50 dentists. And the treatment costs came in between something like $300 and $30,000. And he went to the head of the ADA and he said, you know, as a concerned patient about my oral health, like, what do you recommend I do? And the head of the ADA at the time said, you know, we should get a second and a third opinion. He's like, I got 50 opinions and I'm totally not comforted, right? Dentists are these very unique entities in that there's just so much burden and responsibility on a dentist. And like reading radiography accurately is one of the many things that they need to do, but they're not staking their entire sense of sort of self-worth on it, right? So when we come in with an assistive technology, it's different than when you do that for a pure radiologist, because that is kind of all that they do. And there's a whole different level of, you know, sort of relationship with that technology and potential threat and all that stuff.